Hello, I'm your host, Grover Silcox, coming to you from Daddy Pop's Diner in beautiful downtown Hatboro. Whatever corner of the globe you're from, you most likely have an image of what it means to be an Italian-American from South Philly. It's a culture unto itself, thanks to Italian immigrants who came to America in waves during the early part of the 20th century and settled in South Philadelphia. And with them came their joy of family, eating, and cooking. All of which my first guest covers in her delightfully fun and funny book, Gravy Wars. Lorraine Ranalli, welcome to the counter.
I am honored to be here, Grover. Thank you.
Wow. Hey, you're at a diner. There's food here.
And I'm not on the other side.
Exactly. Right. So as an Italian-American, this should feel right. You should feel right at home.
Whenever I'm at a table, at a counter.
Food, eating, socializing, talking, which brings me to your wonderful book, Gravy Wars. I loved it. I felt like I was sitting at the table of an Italian-American family in South Philadelphia all the way through.
Pretty much that was the intent, you know? and so the whole idea was to just talk about the culture, the traditions, superstitions, our idiosyncrasies.
Oh, yes.
There are many.
It's amazing how food took you to these different subjects.
Yeah, yeah. You know? Originally, I thought I could write just a cookbook with a few anecdotes.
Right.
And then I flipped it upside down. It became a book about the anecdotes and then a few recipes to go along with it. So they're just family recipes, nothing unique. Unless you don't come from the culture, then maybe you'll find something you like.
Right. And of course, gravy is the term that folks from South Philadelphia use to describe sauce.
Yeah,
right?
a lot of neighborhoods. Some neighborhoods still, you know, we'll call it sauce, and the same goes around the country. So there's pockets of Little Italy's everywhere around the country.
But it seems though that if you're in a pocket where they call it gravy, you kind of get chastised a little.
Oh, like, all the time.
No, it's not sauce.
Right.
It's gravy.
Right, right. The debate, the whole book is about, should I give it away this soon?
Sure.
Who makes it best?
Yes, I was going to ask you, who does make it best?
Well, the answer is always, well, I do, of course. But it depends. Now, if you're with your Italian wife,
right,
she does. If you're with your Italian mother-in-law, be careful, you know. Now, if you're an Italian who's married to an Italian and you have an Italian mom and an Italian mother-in-law, you can't win.
You learned how to make gravy from your mom, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's the way it goes. You watch and you learn. And if you don't learn by watching,
you don't learn.
There's no recipes. The toughest part of that book, I have a big disclaimer in the front of it.
Right.
Because nothing is exact. I tried to measure based on what they said. When I was putting it together, I asked all the female members of my family and a couple of girlfriends, you know, give me some of your favorite Italian recipes.
Right.
Nobody had anything right. It took me a year to gather those. I would literally be on the phone with some of them and say, okay, just describe it. And I'm typing as they're describing. Well, what do you mean about a handful? How much do you think that is? How big are your hands? Now, there's a myth out there, and I know it's true in a lot of families, not just Italian, mm-hmm. but any ethnicity, that, you know, we're also prideful about our food, especially
right.
things that we come up with and create ourselves. Mm-hmm. The myth is that no one will ever give you their original recipe. They'll keep a little something out.
Oh.
I promise you that's not the case in my book, because I don't believe in that. It's been my experience. My mother makes so many things very well, but let's just say her pizza.
Right.
And I do exactly what she does.
Mm-hmm.
It does not taste the same.
What is it?
I don't know.
Is it a little bit more salt, a little bit more pepper, oregano?
It could be, and especially when you're not measuring. So I'm not worried about telling you exactly how I make my gravy, because you're going to do it differently.
You actually grew up just outside of South Philly in Delaware County.
All the way out in Delaware County.
Right, but your parents grew up and your whole family, extended family in South Philadelphia.
Everybody was born there, yeah. My parents moved out of Delaware County in 61.
Okay.
So my brother and my sister were born there. I was born in 65. I was born on Broad Street in Methodist Hospital.
Mm-hmm.
So even though my mother at that time was 4 years out of the city, she was still doing all her shopping there till I was at least 8 years old. I was dragged down there on Saturdays, sometimes during the week, if she had the car, because we had one family car. So if she drove my father to work, she'd have the car, and then we'd go get the sausage, get the cheese, different place for everything.
So your mother would go down to like 9th and Washington, where the Italian market is located.
Absolutely, yeah.
Uh-huh.
And we'd walk up and down 9th Street, you know, Christian, there were the C's. So yeah, we
I could still picture, Giordano's produce right there, their market right on the corner.
Mm-hmm.
And then all the others right there. And of course, it's all fresh, right?
All too fresh. I mean, because, you know, there'd be the fish stands. Oh my gosh, I remember as a kid physically getting ill from the odor. Right. I should say the aroma.
Yeah, so you mentioned in the book that you're not a big seafood person, which is kind of a, you know,
makes me the black sheep of the family.
Because in the Italian family, the seafood is
it's huge, and you have La Vigilia coming up, the Feast of the Seven Fishes, Christmas Eve.
Oh, that's right. And did you celebrate that, your family?
Always, and we still do. And it's funny, I took it over from my mother when I moved out on my own, became an adult, and then certainly when I have kids. So, and I talk about the tradition and how the further we get away from the city and our very unique culture, the
more diluted.
Diluted
the
is the word.
Becomes,
so it used to be we only had fish on Christmas Eve, but I was the kid that they boiled a hot dog for. So now I do a lot of different things. I'll do fish. I definitely do some fish.
Right.
I don't always do seven. Mm-hmm. Mom tells me it has to be an odd number or it's bad luck. They're very superstitious.
Again, the superstitions.
Yeah,
you get into that a little bit.
I do.
Like the maloik, is that what it's called?
Yeah,
the evil eye.
Malocchio, but of course we call it maloiks. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, we grew up Italian Catholic.
Right.
So you'll have a crucifix on one wall and you'll have garlic to ward off the evil spirits on the other.
Right.
And I'm like, Mom, pick one, I wrote a whole play about this. Well, a series of vignettes.
La Famiglia?
La Famiglia.
Familia.
Yeah, we'll get you.
Yeah, you're right. See, I'm still learning.
It's great. But what I did was I started writing these vignettes just to promote the book when it came out. And a couple of them ran at a Colonial Playhouse, a small theater in Delaware County, as part of their summer short play festival.
Right.
Then I strung them together and made a show. And you would appreciate this, I hope. It's comedic. It's just slapstick silly. It's based on a fictitious family.
Right.
I can't confirm nor deny that it's based on my family.
Well, your book is hilarious. I mean, your little asides and the quips that you make and the observations about the family. It's hilarious.
It's easy to do. You have to write about something that you're passionate about or, an expert on. And the way I came up with Gravy Wars was Christmas Eve, La Familia. Mm-hmm. I was literally getting agita because people were coming in.
Right.
And where does everybody come? I have food everywhere around the house. They come right into the kitchen.
Right. In the Italian household, the kitchen is the command center.
It basically.
And mom is usually the commander, correct?
That's right.
Because you say that in your book.
Don't mess with her.
Like, don't just walk in and, think you're going to even help.
Right.
Unless asked.
Right. That's a good point. And that's what people would do. They congregate and, you've got the oven going and this going. And so I was really getting myself all worked up this one Christmas Eve 2005. And that's when I said, this is comical. And the whole idea that I literally had chest pains, I'm like, oh my gosh, is this going to be my fate on Christmas Eve?
Right.
And I said, this is absolutely comical. This will be my book.
Even your description of the dessert, it's not just like, one cannoli.
No. There's a dessert table. We have to do a spread. And if you don't eat it, you're going to insult them.
And that was another thing with your etiquette. Like, first you have to, when they offer, you say, no, I don't want to put you out. And then they offer again, and then you go, you're okay to go
ahead. And most times they'll just put it in front of you. And if you don't take a little bit, take a sip, take a bite, then
it's an insult.
They're going to talk about you.
Well, they never had to ask me twice. Okay. So I love to eat, and I love the Italian-American culture, and I love the fact that you're with us today.
And I love the counterculture. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Lorraine Ranalli, a woman steeped in South Philly Italian-American culture, who knows when gravy's sauce and sauce is gravy.